I think we can say that there are a lot of special things about the past that we need to preserve as lawyers, including what makes the lawyer-client relationship special, when that trust and reputation that comes from being someone's trusted advisor. But looking forward, I think there was a general sense of optimism today. People are very open-minded about change and what can happen if people put their mind to it.
In Magna Carta, there is a clause whereby King John promised that he would appoint as judges only those who knew the law well and wanted to keep it. At a stroke, he established the English judiciary and the legal profession. Since then, the legal profession and judiciary have developed in a symbiotic relationship, which has been very important for the success of both. Solicitors, barristers have been officers of the court. Their first duty is to the court rather than their clients. It's that particular duty in relation to the administration of justice that distinguishes the legal profession from all other professions and distinguishes it as a profession as opposed simply from being a provider of services in an industry designed to provide dispute resolution services. It's the obligation which ensures that so far as the legal profession is concerned, the customer is not always right. It reflects the obligation of lawyers to advise their clients when they're not right and to assist the court to ensure that litigation that shouldn't occur doesn't occur. I think that if the legal profession is to continue into the future as recognisably what it is today, it's the preservation of those particular cultural values that's essential. Once that idea of the legal profession's identity is lost, then we won't be able to recognise whatever the legal profession might turn into in 40 years' time.
What I've learnt is that embracing technology, moving with the times, tends to make you a better and longer-lasting practitioner.